kidney transplant versus biopsy. So let's start with kidney transplant. Before the surgery, clients are put on immunosuppressants to suppress the immune response from rejecting that new organ. So cyclosporin is the drug of choice, which I call cyclosperin. It spares that new organ from rejection. And after the surgery, we monitor urine output. So remember, urine output 30 mL or less means the kidneys are in distress. We also monitor for signs of infection. That low-grade fever is typically the number one tested on most question banks. And signs and symptoms of organ rejection. So hypertension and pain at the site. And we put clients on a diet that is low in fat and high in sodium. Now ATI mentions teaching for a client with end-stage kidney disease awaiting a kidney transplant. The correct answer was hemodialysis is sometimes needed after surgery. And this is done to help the body accommodate to that new kidney. Now for renal biopsy, this is where a tissue sample is taken from the kidney to determine certain diseases, just like how we do other biopsies with cancer patients. But the key point here is that the kidney is very vascular, so bleeding is a big complication to know for exams, since it's the most deadly. So before the procedure, we discontinue blood thinners at least 7 days prior. So anticoagulants like heparin and warfarin must be discontinued. Antiplatelet agents like aspirin and clopidogrel, brand name Plavix, and NSAIDs like ibuprofen and naproxen. And lastly, supplements. We remember the acronym EGO. So E for vitamin E, the G for ginkgo, ginseng, and garlic, the O for omega-3s, and the S for St. John's wort. All of these guys must be discontinued at least 7 days prior to the procedure. Now, after the procedure, the priority is to assess the vital signs every 15 minutes for the first hour. Guys, write that down. That's 4 times in the first hour. We're monitoring for key signs that indicate blood loss, like tachycardia and hypotension, that low blood pressure. And then after the vitals, we assess the surgical site for bleeding and, key term, position the client on their back, on the affected side, to provide pressure to prevent bleeding. Remember, these are the priorities here before assessing kidney labs. And a little side note, never place the client on their stomach or prone position because the big risk for bleeding since there's no pressure on that puncture site. Always put the client on their back on the affected side to provide pressure. All right, guys, that wraps it up for this.